Okay, been a while since I've done a Belgian-style ale, but here we are. I get to bust out the St. Bernardus chalice once again for this one. This is a triple ale, and it comes to us from Easton, Pennsylvania, Weyerbacher Brewing Company's Merry Monk's triple-style ale. Now, Weyerbacher Brewing founded in 1995 by Dan and Sue Weyerbach. Weyerbacher coming from the original pronunciation of their ancestors' names 200 years ago. In Germany, and they converted an old livery stable in Easton into a brewery, and that's basically where they are today, almost 18 years later. This is one of their seasonal, actually not seasonal, this is one of their year-round beers, as a matter of fact. They brew Merry Monks year-round, and if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure this is a different label and a brand new label here for Merry Monks. The label art different than the past label art for the Merry Monks. I think that's very, very recent. So we're doing this review on October 18th right now, and this may be the first batch that's been bottled with the new label. I don't know. Triple Ale, of course, as we mentioned before, we've done the St. Bernardus Triple Ale, and we've done Golden Monkey Triple Ale from Victory. So I gave the definition of Triple Ale, and as you know, they use three times the amount of malts that a normal single malt Belgian-style ale uses. So that, you know, basically gave birth to the term triple. This is a bottle-conditioned ale. They put sugar and yeast in it before the brewing process. That's what that means. Also, they use Pilsner malts, Belgian yeast malts as well, or Belgian yeast rather, in this beer. So, looking for a very golden color triple ale here. We'll probably get that fruity kind of banana-y kind of smell that you usually get from triples. And we'll pour it into our St. Bernardus chalice. And we'll see a very golden, golden, golden color. Pour the whole thing in here. There we go. Yeah, very golden color, and as soon as I'm pouring it out, I'm met with that banana kind of bread kind of smell that you're used to with the triple ale. About a half a finger of head, and lots of fine particulates bubbling up very finely. I don't know if you can make that out or not, but definitely a lot going on in this one, as you can come to expect with triples, basically. Aroma here, very, very pungent banana aroma. I mean, more so than I think most triples that I've had. Now, I'm kind of getting the a bit of the yeasty kind of malts that are kind of intermixing with the banana. Very effervescent. I mean, it's very widespread aroma. As I said, it just hit my nose right away as soon as I poured it out. Now I'm kind of getting that smell, that commingling that you usually get from triples. But it took a little while to get past the banana smell. That's the one thing that just basically just hits you right away with Merry Monks. I kind of remember that from having Merry Monks before, which I have, it's been a while, but I have had Merry Monks. Let's give this one a taste. Very effervescent. I mean, basically almost dissolves in your mouth at first taste. A very, very full taste. The banana part just invades you right off the get-go. Tasty. I'm not going to say that it's quite as tasty as Golden Monkey, which, of course, as you know from my prior review, is a favorite of mine, sentimental favorite of mine. As far as the St. Bernardus, that is a real Belgian triple. Very well done. This one's a well-done beer. I think it's a little too heavy on the banana notes, though. That said, still getting the pungent, kind of, I almost want to say cinnamony, kind of aftertones to this. After the banana's done, you're definitely getting some kind of spice, some kind of nice, like, nutmeggy, cinnamony kind of spice to this. I would have a feeling if they threw in a little pumpkin, it would be a pumpkin ale easily. However, it is a triple. It is very banana heavy. Not my favorite triple out there, but definitely a very drinkable triple to me. I'll give Weyerbacher Merry Monk's Ale a 7 out of 10.